And now to a follow-up to that secret fund used by the Department of Education. For the first time, the former state superintendent is speaking out about that damaging state audit. Listen to this.
I was totally disappointed in our state auditor in the fact that he had never called me or gotten any of the facts straight.
Well, that's right. Tonight, Sandy Garrett is telling her side of the story, and KOCO's Carla Wade is live with these new details. Carla.
Well, Anita, the former state superintendent says she never wrote a check or actually oversaw any of those accounts, but she maintains that they were perfectly legal and above board.
A report by the state auditor and inspector uncovered what that agency says were three unauthorized bank accounts where more than $2 million was deposited. The auditor says that money was solicited from donors on state time. The report says donors thought the money was going to a nonprofit group and that it was hidden from oversight. Former state superintendent Sandy Garrett denies that claim.
Well, that is totally not accurate. We're very transparent in everything we did at the Department of Education.
Garrett also says State Auditor Gary Jones did not make every attempt to contact her or anyone else that could have explained the existence of these accounts. The report says otherwise, that Garrett and other people at the department did not return calls or emails.
Well, that's disappointing after this many years of service and now retirement to see that something like this from a state.
Garrett says the expenses, which included hotel stays and thousands spent on beer, wine, and food at Oklahoma restaurants, were not extravagant and were a part of conferences educators have held every year for years.
Now, Garrett says that she did seek legal advice about those accounts. Coming up at 6, we'll have more on that and why she says that this was private money and not state money. Reporting live in the newsroom, Carla Wade, KOCO, Eyewitness News 5.
Okay, Carla. Well, Garrett also added that during her entire 20 years in office, her administration passed every audit.